Hey Taurus, how you doing? Going to be doing your reading here for end of August. It is a general reading, so just take what resonates. And we're just going to jump right into it. See what energies, what messages are coming out here for you. And see, first card that's coming out here for Taurus. What do we got going on? And flip the energies if you need to. This may be you. This may be someone that you're dealing with. So we do start off the reading here with the Queen of Pentacles. So we do start off with your energy here. So let's see what's crossing you, what's blocking you here. End of August, what's going on here for Taurus? We do have the Knight of Swords, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. So Knight of Swords is sometimes communication. This could be, news that comes towards you here. Let's see recent past for Taurus. Recent past. We do have the Magician here. Okay. Gemini energy. So you could be dealing with a Gemini or another air sign, or just, this is a sense of you are in this energy of trying to get things going, trying to manifest something here. But there's something blocking. Either maybe you're waiting on something. This could be communication. It feels as though, like, some of you guys are really moving forward, really having this sense of, like, I need to move forward. But then actually, it's like, something inside really weighs you down in another situation. And it's like you feel that forward moment, you feel that freedom, but then over time, or throughout the day, or some days when you wake up here, there's a feeling of like nostalgia. That's what I'm getting here. I'm just looking at the Knight of Swords and feeling that. So let's see the focus, because you want some sort of communication. You want maybe a truth to come out. You want something to clear. Let's see your focus here for Taurus. We have the Five of Cups. See, you're focusing on something here, a relationship, a situation. The Three Cups have spilled. We do have the Four of Wands here. So maybe it was a home environment. Maybe you lived with someone here. Could be family situations too. But Five of Cups energy, you can see this person's just looking at the cups that spilled. So it's just like all that time and energy put into something. Is not there, and you're just focusing on that. It feels like a little bit of reflection, a little bit of past, and trying to. It's like a stage of where you are finally processing something to move on is really what's going on here. Okay. Let's see the possibilities here for Taurus. What is the possibilities here for Taurus? We do have the King of Cups, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio energy. Near future here. What is the near future here for Taurus? What is the near future for Taurus here? We do have the Emperor. All right, Aries energy here. Let's see in your power, what's going on? It's gonna turn out this way. I'm telling you off the beginning of the reading, I can already feel it. This is more tuned into end of August, and we are coming into retrograde here. So there is going to be energy of past people coming back. I'm feeling that water energy here. We have the Emperor here. I feel like it doesn't matter the gender, but I feel like you are moving into your power here. Now, for some of you guys, you may be thinking, I'm already in my power. I think you're going to go through something else here. There's another final stage of healing before this actually takes off. Yeah, that full moon in Aquarius. I think your last reading, I said things are going to resurface. And I can see that here. Whoever this resonates for, the things are resurfacing. And I was talking about healing as well, the star. And it's not something bad. It's not like something where why you're in this energy or anything like that. This is actually a healthy energy to move on. You know what I mean? You have to feel what you're feeling about that person, that situation. Again, I'm feeling this is like a final stage of letting go. You may have felt a little, energy's depleted, down a little bit here, something like that. We have death, transformation. That's in your power, your feels. I'm picking up. You guys are moving towards. You're having this awakening. We have the High Priestess here now too. Scorpio energy. We have death. There's things ending in your life. There's new things beginning in your life. There's, other or new realizations of what you're feeling inside of you as well. Okay. For some of you guys, you may be tapping into something to where you felt like you were way past it, but it's coming back up again. Again, this is like a continuation of your last reading. Except there's movement here. There's movement forward. All right. So that's good. That's actually good news here. So let's see your environment here. What is the environment here for Taurus? Some of you guys could be having a lot of dreams here. See, Eight of Cups. You are moving forward. See, Pisces energy. I knew there was a past connection. You're thinking about Six of Cups here, Scorpio energy. A lot of emotions going on here. But in your environment, your mindset is to move forward. You're walking away from this, okay? So you are letting go. But, you know, if you have, even for people that have tried to or felt as though you let go of this situation months ago, maybe even years ago, I feel as though this is the feelings coming back up because this is a final stage of letting it go. So it's kind of repeating myself here, but it's like, it's really what this message is saying is that if you're feeling down or you're feeling like you miss something, you feel nostalgia, maybe dreams of your past person, maybe you're listening to music of, you know, someone here that you're thinking of and it reminds you of that person, or maybe it's a song that you guys used to listen to. There's something like that going on here. But again, I do, you know, if you feel like, oh, this person's coming back and this is going to be together again, you know, there is, Knight of Swords is blocking. I mean, that is communication coming towards you. You are here in the reading with the Queen of Pentacles. King of Cups, we have the Magician here. I feel as though it is more of letting this go is really what's going on, okay? Not, you know, the energy is there of someone wanting to return. But again, retrograde, we're always going to pick up past energy. We'll get deeper into it. The cards are not all out yet. So let me see the hopes and fears here for Taurus. What is the hopes and fears for Taurus here? We have the Ten of Pentacles. So, you know, it is an energy of wanting long-term stability, growth. You do want a connection. You know, some of you guys here are looking at kind of just building something new for yourself, but also wanting that stability. There's a sense of wanting independence, but also wanting to be with someone and share some memories, new memories with, and create something, a foundation for yourself with someone else as well. So you're focused on this Ten of Pentacles, but you're also focused on this Five of Cups right now. So you're kind of in between of letting go and moving forward. And that's, it's kind of scary. There's a feeling of like, you know that you're moving forward. You know intuitively here that things are changing, you're transforming. You're moving into a better, you know, situation for yourself. But it's also accepting the fact that it has ended, this cycle, okay? And that could be sad, you know, that's a feeling of just disappointing. And you have to feel through that, though. You have to let that go. And that's good, though, that whoever's in, you know, feeling this is actually really doing the work inside, not just saying it. So let's see the potential outcome here for Taurus. I say potential because you have free will to change this here. So let's see what's going on. What is the potential outcome here for Taurus? The potential outcome. Look at this. The Sun. Happiness. Leo energy. You know, we have the potential. I'm building up to this right now. Just pay, you gotta get prepared for this one. We have the Sun as the potential outcome, okay? But the bottom of the deck is kind of like an overall for me when I look at the bottom of the deck. Look what's going on, Three of Swords. See, so it does match up to what I'm talking about. There is a sense of healing, taking care of yourself. For some of you guys, this is like taking a break from things, pulling yourself back from the day-to-day just to take care of yourself, you know, your mental health, things of that, right? So there's a lot going on here. There's a lot going on here. But I can see towards the end of this reading here, there is going to be movement forward in terms of success and happiness here, okay? And it's a lot of it of you getting into your power here, Emperor energy. It doesn't matter the gender, just, you know, the masculine energy. And you're moving away from things. And also, look at this. The reading starts off with the Queen of Pentacles. And the Queen of Pentacles energy, this is a very nurturing, forgiving type of energy too. So you're in this, you know, you're in something here where you are internally forgiving what the situation, you know what I mean? And that takes a lot of power to do so. So let's just get some more clarification here. What's going on? I just see some healing going on here. I see walking away. I see success here. But let's see what's going on in this Five of Cups energy. And we do also have to look at this Knight of Swords. Why is this Knight of Swords blocking as well? So first, I do want to see the Five of Cups on the focus area. What is this Five of Cups here? We do have the Ace of Pentacles coming out. Let's get one more card on that. Now, the Ace of Pentacles is opportunities. You know, maybe you feel like you missed out on other opportunities. Let me get one more card. The Three of Swords coming out as well. So the Five of Cups, we have looking at missed out on opportunities or things that you could have done and put your mind into, where you feel like you could have been very far. But then also your focus on this Three of Swords energy. Okay, so it's a mix of, you know, a heartbreak, pain, ending, health. But it's also you looking at a new opportunity, you know? It's like that too, because you have the Five of Cups. That's three cups. You have the Three of Swords, and then the Two Cups here is like you're also turning around and seeing the opportunity for you. For some of you guys, that could be the case as well. So it's again, in between. You're just in between right now. Let's see this Knight of Swords. We do have the Queen of Cups here underneath, so King of Cups, Queen. It could be, yeah, it's definitely a partnership that you're dealing with. Let me see the Knight of Swords. Why is the Knight of Swords blocking here? I feel like somebody wants to communicate. Maybe even you want to communicate just to, like, just clear the air on something here. I feel like that's what's going on. Let me see the Knight of Swords. We have the Ten of Cups here. See, there is someone here that is thinking of a past situation. The Queen of Cups is underneath here again. A family situation, you could have been married to this person before. You know, again, it's just a situation where somebody does see you as their Ten of Cups still. I feel like you see this person like that at one point, but there's a feeling of, you know, it's done, it's over. That's really what's going on here. I don't feel like, you know, this person's coming in wanting commitment, wanting to start something new. Could be for some of you guys. I get a card on this Ten of Cups here. Get another card on this Ten of Cups. My nose is itching. You know, the Aries reading, I was doing that, and all of a sudden my nose started itching. And I said in the video, I said, you know, I don't know why when I do readings my nose itches, you know. And I looked it up, and it was like, you know, says something good is coming towards you or something's coming towards you. I get a comment, and someone's like, allergies. I'm like, I guess that's too. But it still doesn't explain why when I hit pause, you know, the nose stops itching. I still haven't figured out this stuff. I mean, for some of you guys, somebody is coming towards you wanting commitment. You have the Ten of Cups, the Page of Cups, and the Hierophant, okay? You do have that return coming in, Taurus. Now, I mentioned your reading here, retrograde, is going to bring that energy back. So we're getting into this energy where, you know, your person is also having reflection, right? So this person is also going through an energy of reflecting, thinking, nostalgia, you know, just memories of that. So you might be imaging, or, you know, that person might be going through this and you're going through this. It's a mix of you letting go, but this person's feeling as though you're letting go. You know, like energetic movement, like you're moving forward. This person's feeling that. And now also in this Five of Cups energy, it's kind of going that way too. So this communication here, this Knight of Swords, this person wants to come in and offer something here to restart something that they used to have, but it's a challenge here. See, this is not one of those things where, you know, it's in your challenge area, because there's a movement forward. Look at this, Ten of Pentacles to the Sun, right? Walking away, transformation. Look at all this movement forward, Emperor energy, being in your power. And then you have this challenge that comes in towards you, which is communication saying, hey, let's repeat the cycle. You know what I mean? That's kind of what's going on here. Now let's ask the question though, because somebody does want to start up something from the past, but what is the outcome of that? You know, what is the potential outcome of that? Again, these are general readings. So if that's what you want, you know, then that's fine. That's up to you. You have free will. See, there is a reunion coming in. I feel as though there's someone coming back in for you, Taurus, from the past that is wanting some sort of, you can see the cards, right? Okay. Wants that Three of Cups energy, Cancer energy. It's like wanting a reunion, wanting to come together here, wanting to go out, wanting, you know, there's going to be different for everyone, but there's a reconnection here. Somebody does see you as a Ten of Cups wants to offer a Page of Cups energy. This could just be, hey, can we be friends again? You know, it could be a lot of different ways here. You're going to have to figure that part out. Magician energy here. What do you want to do? You know, that's really what it is here. What do you want to do? Do you feel as though that's going to be part of something of what you're trying to create? Because look at the outcome. You want this happiness. You want that, right? Now, some of you are going to be like, well, if this person comes back, that's my son, right? That's the happiness. That's my Ten of Pentacles. Hey, if that's what you feel, that's what you feel, because everyone is in a different journey. So not everyone left a situation in a bad, you know, setting, right? Like there was some of us disconnected from people because we may have not had a choice. You know, something came in. Maybe there was a third party that interfered. Maybe someone said something. Maybe there was gossip. Maybe there was a misunderstanding, right? It could be light as that to where you can create this new connection again. And maybe that is part of your Ten of Pentacles in the Sun. You see what I'm trying to say? So don't get discouraged when someone from the past comes back. You will know. You are the one that's going to know whether this can work or not work. Okay? So just keep that in mind if you're watching tarot as well, especially the general ones. All right? So you're going to be in a decision-making time. Two of Swords, you're not going to know which direction to go towards because you're going to start feeling good of moving forward, and this is going to come in for you, okay? Let's just get three cards overall here. See if there's any advice, anything else coming up in this reading here for Taurus. Trying to see if there's anything else. Let's look at the Death card here in your power, because that is a transformation. Let's see if we can get anything from that. We have Justice here. I mean, you know, if you feel like for some of you guys, you know, maybe someone did do something towards you here, cheated on you, trying to be sneaky, whatever the case is, karma's coming out, all right? So, you know, it's Libra energy. Understand that things are going to be balanced the way it needs to be. So it's going to be out of your control. So focus on yourself, focus on transformation, work on you, do things that make you happy. And if this comes in for you, great, you know, you can figure out what you want to do there. But this is happening to whoever has done that to you, okay? So just keep that in mind. And again, if it is you, we all have to go through some sort of karma. If we make a mistake, you have to deal with it. That's the way it is. We signed up for that when we made that mistake, you know what I mean? So we've all been through it. So it's just one of those things you have to kind of go through. But in this reading, it does feel like someone is coming back towards you, wanting to communicate, wanting to reunite. I don't feel like this person is coming with, you know, bad intentions or, you know, wanting to break your heart or, you know, things like that. I'm not picking that up. I do feel like a sense of cautious, though, because I feel like you can get sucked into something that may not be so good for you because there's other opportunities here for you. You know what I mean? So I hope that makes sense. All right. Yeah, there's a Seven of Swords here, but I feel like that's because of this here, this Justice. So let's get the three cards overall here. Some of you guys, you know, you're also in this energy of like the Sun in reverse as well. So, you know, things are going to get light for you. It could feel very heavy energy, like I said. Do some practices if you need to. If you're not into all that, some people are not into incense and sage and stuff. So go take a walk, you know, ground your energy, leave all that crap out there and then come back. You know what I mean? That's kind of what you want to do. That's what I'm picking up as well. I feel like that's just going to help you with more, just having more energy. I feel like some of you guys have felt depleted here in some way, okay? I do get the Seven of Cups, the Three of Wands, and then the King of Pentacles here with the Nine of Cups here. So a lot of you guys are going to be moving, you know, towards your wish fulfillment. You know, maybe there's a connection that does come back and it's like, let bygones be bygones and move forward. Maybe this person does support you, you know, in a different way, more of a friendship level. For some of you guys, you just have a lot of history. You know, you just feel very connected to this person anyway. But you're going to get a lot more opportunities coming towards you. Three of Wands here. You've been waiting for your ships to come in. So that is coming in for you. But you're also looking out in the future. And you're kind of going into, look at this, King and Queen of Pentacles here. So there's a possible new connection coming in for you as well. So this Nine of Cups energy, wish fulfillment. Let me just see this King of Pentacles. Because we have the Queen and King. So I feel like there's a new connection coming in. Who's this King of Pentacles here? We have the Knight of Wands, Aries, Leo, Sag energy. Somebody's got their eyes on you. Let's see. We have the World. There is someone new there. that has their eyes on you here, Taurus. They have a lot of they already know you, okay? I feel as though this person either has their eye on you, they see you in some way. You know, this could just be social media. Maybe someone does admire you off social media, or they see what you're doing. You know, but they're building up a lot of interest here, okay? They're attracted to you, definitely attracted. They want to start a new beginning with you. Ace of Cups energy, it's like they want to offer something. I feel like it is coming, but it also feels like you're going through something. This person has a feeling that you're going through another situation. So it's like waiting for that moment here, right? So first, it's like you moving forward, taking care of yourself, and this new connection does come in. Aries, Leo, Sag, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. We have Aries, Leo, Sag again. Could be Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio as well, okay? So Taurus, that is your reading. I'm going to get you guys an oracle here, and then we'll close it out. If this reading did resonate for you guys, please do hit that like button. And I'm trying to see if there's anything else that I missed. It's kind of nice to do a reading without any drama, man. Sometimes energies do have that. A lot of jealousy has been coming out lately, too. So be sure to check your moon and rising signs as well, so you can get a better idea. So we do have the gorilla. Means peace coming out here for you. I haven't used this deck in a while, so I'm not going to read you the whole thing. There's a lot to it, but it's the gorilla, which means peace. It says to seek or negotiate for peace is a position of strength, not weakness. Choose peace rather than war. Strong leaders lead by example. The greatest kind of strength involves restraint. Don't judge a book by its cover. Okay, Taurus, that is your reading, and until next time, we'll see you. You guys have a good one.